Hi children, welcome back again. Okay, in this video we are going to discuss the continuation part of the last video. That is, the topic name is parts of the plant. So we have discussed some parts of the plant, the leaf and the stem, and how do they are going to help. Okay, and what are the examples for the root, and what are the storage of root, and what are the examples for the storage of the food in the stem. We have discussed in the last video. So in this video we are going to discuss the next part of the plant, that is leaf. Then we know that leaf is a most important part of the plant. Without leaf, plant is not at all going to live. How do you have any idea how without leaf the plant will not live? For example, there must be a leaf for a plant to be alive, because leaves are going to help the plant in the preparation of the food. Yes. Okay, about this we will discuss in the next, after some time. So we will learn the leaf is the one of the most important part of the plant, and this is how the leaf looks. We have different types of the leaf. There is a difference in the type of the leaf. I mean, type means what? Of course, almost all the leaf, 80% of leaf are green in color. But they are different in size, broadness, length. Size means that is short, big or small, and the length, and thus like this venation. Venation means patterns inside the leaf are the different. For example, rose plant leaf is different from other leaf. You can say mango leaf, you can say lemon leaf, you can say other flower leaf like hibiscus flower leaf. So if you take some five types of leaf, they look different from each other. They are different in the size, in the length, and even they are different from in the venation also. Then but each and every leaf has the some particular parts. For example, this middle part is running from here. This will run from the stem part of the stem branch of the plant. That is, this will run throughout the tip of the leaf. This is called as the midrib. In the leaf, it is called as the midrib. This middle line is called as midrib. And this outside of the leaf is called as stalk. And this small like thread-like structures will be there. No, these called as the leaf veins, or we can just say veins. Just how we have the veins for our body, even the leaf is also having the veins. And these exposed part, this plain part which is exposed to the sunlight, is called as the lamina. And then this is stalk, and this small pores will be there. You might have seen sometimes early in the morning when you get up, so there will be a water collection on the leaf. So then from where the water has come? Actually, water has not come from outside. If it is rainy season, it's okay. Then if even though there is no rainy season, morning, because of the humidity, the water will come. Water is present on the leaf part, because that will come from the tree, from the plant. It has not come from the outside, so it has come from the plant. Then how it has come, then how we have the small pores or small holes for our body. Similarly, leaf is also having small tiny pores or holes on this body. Then those holes are called as the stomata. Those holes will help to exchange the water. How the water drop has collected on the leaf early in the morning, no? Because it has collected, excess water was there in the body, so it has come out. Similarly, even the stomatas are going to exchange the air also. Carbon dioxide they will take, and oxygen they will leave to surrounding. This is how they will exchange the air also. So like this, these all are the some important parts of the leaf. That may be any venation type of leaf, or that may be any size of the leaf. The parts of the leaf are going to remain same. Then how do leaf is going to help? Even as the carrot, as the radish, as the ginger, as the potato, how we will get some eating edible parts Similarly, from the leaf also we have cabbage, broccoli, spinach. Like this we have the vegetables. So we use them as a vegetable to eat. Then actually what are those cabbage, spinach and this broccoli? Those are the extra foods which are stored in the leaf part. Understood? Whatever we are eating, no, those are the extra foods. Other than this, we eat some other leaves direct. Like coriander leaf may be there, curry leaf may be there, and the spinach is there, menthe is there, methi we call it, is there, and many leafy vegetables are there. We eat directly or make them salad or we prepare bhaji of that one. Like this, we take them as a leafy vegetable in our food. Other than this, leaf is going to help in a most important process, that is production of food. I don't know whether you have heard or not. Photosynthesis is a process in which leaf is going to produce food for the whole plant. This is the area where the photosynthesis takes place by with the help of the sunlight, carbon dioxide. And next, more important is inside the leaf to be green color, there will be one pigment called as the chlorophyll. This pigment is called as chlorophyll. By using this chlorophyll, sunlight, carbon dioxide, water and minerals from the surrounding or environment, leaf is going to prepare its own food. That food will pass throughout the whole part of the plant. And it is given to the other part of the plant just like a energy. So that other part of the plants are going to get the energy. This is what the most important work of the leaf. Other than this, even leaf are helpful to adopt the plant for the particular areas. How the coconut tree leaf is there, how the hydrilla leaf leaves are there in the water, how the rose leaves are there, how the leaf of the lotus is there. So this is how the modification or the size and this broadness of the leaf is helping the whole plant to adapt to its surrounding area. This is how the leaf helps in the preparation of food, in the exchange of water and air, and even as eating edible vegetable, and even it helps to adjust or adapt the whole plant to its surrounding or its habitat. This is how the leaf part is going to help. Children, I hope this was the most important thing you have understood, whatever we have discussed today's video. So in the next video, we will discuss about the flower and the seeds. Okay, how do they have, they are there in the plant and how do they help for the plant. And next, we will go for the exercise part. Other than this, if you have some extra knowledge or extra ideas also, you can go through that. Okay. So by this, I would like to end this video. Before ending, I would like to give you some questions. Draw the leaf and mention, label its part. First question. And then, what is photosynthesis? What is photosynthesis? And explain this. I hope you will do this homework. And let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and bye-bye.